perhaps even most people who have never been here, think that Hong Kong is just a forest of skyscrapers with millions and millions of people crowding every square centimeter. But that's not true. Only 30 minutes away from the manic crowds of Central is Lantau Island, designated Green Lung of Hong Kong. And on Lantau Island is the village of Pui O. The village is ostensibly a sleepy backwater. But look a little bit closer, and you'll find the world seething with frantic activity. Well, some activity. My name is Cecilia, and normally I'm a Cantonese fundamentalist. That means I work tirelessly day and night to make Cantonese a world language. But today I want to be a Buffalomentalist. I want to talk to you about the water buffalo or Pui O. Why? Well, they're beautiful, they're funky, they have great fashion sense, always dressed in leather, and they have a death sentence hanging over them. Did you know that these buffalo originally came from Vietnam? Yeah, they were brought over by the English and French in the late 1800s to till the fields of Lantau in endless patience. In the 70s, people started abandoning their fields and the buffalo became feral. So nowadays, they don't lift a finger all day, just lie around, eat, burp, sleep, do it, give birth, let the calves drink, and turn out for the occasional fight. This is the buffalo fighting stance, cruising for a bruising. But when I see the buffalo taking up the fighting stance, I have to admit, sometimes I try to get out of the way a little, because I know that soon there'll be a high-octane buffalo chase. But the fights tend to be rather half-hearted affairs, with the participants drifting off to eat or to pee. Not only pee, also poo. And it is in fact this poo that has made so many people angry with the water buffalo to the point where they want to get rid of them. Yes, kill them. But the poo actually has great value. You can use it as a fertilizer, it has medicinal properties, and during an apocalypse, you can use it as firewood for cooking. Over the years, the wetlands of Pui O have become their own ecosystem, greatly helped by the water buffalo. Because of the lovely poo and the insects it and the buffalo themselves attract, the area is a magnet for birds. buffalo with their wide, sturdy hooves make paths through the fields, irrigating them. The animals also need to make big water holes to shower after a long day of eating. This water keeps the wetlands green. Also, imagine what would happen if these four-legged free gardeners didn't turn out every day to keep the grass at a manageable height. The wetlands would become an unbearable thicket and wilderness, and you'd have to pay people to come and hack it away. If the grass was allowed to grow long, the birds would never be able to control the mosquito menace. Just like with a tree, you can tell the age of a water buffalo by the rings on its horns, without having to cut them off. Every buffalo has its own unique horn pattern. Inside their noses, the buffalo have a kind of air valve that allows them to stay underwater for long periods of time. Therefore, if you adopt a water buffalo, you should never put a ring through its nose. The next time it went swimming, it would drown like a shark without its dorsal fin. Lantau's water buffalo are laid-back and placid animals who leave people alone if we don't bother them. But they do sometimes show a mild curiosity towards people and other animals. Also inspire other animals to embrace a vegetarian lifestyle. But beautiful and highly useful as these animals are, they are now under threat. Not only from individual people who would love to see them disappear, but also from buildings and building debris encroaching on the wetland, as well as increased traffic on Lantau. When I look at these beautiful animals, I find it almost inconceivable that some people look at them and want to kill them. But there you are. If you like the water buffalo in Pui O and want to support them and all the cattle on Lantau, please join the Lantau Buffalo Association. If we get the numbers up, maybe when you come back here in 10 years' time, this area will still look like this, with the water buffalo still grazing, being a free gardener and having the good life they deserve.